Hi guys, welcome to Techie Ocean. In this tutorial, we'll see how to cache data using Impure pipe. So let's begin. So we have a very simple example in which we are calling a get API and just simply populating the fields in the grid. So let's see the code. So we just have a class name as comments, which have fields like post ID, ID, name, email, and body. So these are the fields which are written by the API, that is here. So in the app.component.ts, we just have a list of comments, which is an array of type comments, which is used to fill the data. And the ng-on init, we are just having an API service which is calling the get comments API, and we are just filling the data written from the get API in this list of comments, that is this array. And the API service, we are just simply calling this get API, which we have seen here. And in the app.component.html, we are simply looping through this list of comments and populating the ID, name, email, and body. So our task here is to remove the HTTP service here, which we are calling in the app.component, and we are simply going to call this API in the impure pipe and storing in the cache. So let's see it. First, we'll comment this out. So I'll create a class name as cacheapi pipe.ts. So we are going to create a pipe now, impure pipe. We are first going to import the HTTP client. We'll import the pipe and pipe transform from Angular core. So we'll create a class name as cacheapi pipe, which implements pipe transform. And we'll just name this pipe as cacheapi. And we'll just make this pipe impure by marking pure as false. So this will be an impure pipe. So as I said, we are going to cache the API result here in this impure pipe. We are going to define two variables. First is cached API data. Here we are going to store the data, and the cached API URL. Here we are going to pass the URL of the API directly, and we are going to invoke the API here itself. I'm going to simply call a constructor where I'm going to inject our HTTP client for invoking the API. I'm going to declare the inbuilt transform method. Here I'm going to simply pass the URL of the API. So in this transform method, I'm just simply going to write, if URL is not equal to cached API URL, then I'm going to mark cached API data as null, and the cached API URL, I'm simply going to pass the URL, which is been passed to the impure pipe. And after that, I'm directly going to invoke the API this way. this.http.getURL, and I'm going to call the subscribe method in which I'm going to fill this dot cache API data from the result returned by the API. That is, I'm going to fill the cache API data with the result of the API here. And I'm going to simply return it here. This dot cache API data. Now in the app.model.ts, I'm just going to import our cache API pipe, and I'm just simply going to declare it here in the declaration. And in the HTML, I'm just going to remove this list of comments, and I'm directly going to call the URL of the API and the pipe name, that is cache API, and the URL, that is this. And I'm going to pass that URL here. So you can see, I'm simply going to call the URL here itself, and I'm going to pass the pipe here, that is cache API pipe and the URL, which is going to go in the pipe transform URL here. And this is simply going to invoke the API. So how we will know that the data is actually coming from the server or from the cache? So we'll do some changes here first to identify that it's coming from the cache object. So inside the transform method, I'm simply going to write console.log cache pipe is called. And then I'm going to log the cached API URL here. If I'm going to call the API, then here I'm going to simply write server call. That is, API has been called and the data is written from the server. And in else, I'm going to simply write console.log data is written from cache, not from the server. That is, first time the URL will be coming here. We are going to check whether this URL is already there in the cache API URL. If no, then we are just going to write console.log server call and we are going to just invoke that API, and in else we are just going to write data written from cache. So let's run this and you can see the data is written. We'll just check the logs. So in the log you can see the first time the cache pipe is called and it's a server call. Then we are just calling continuously the impure pipe. As you know, the impure pipe gets invoked each and every time. So each and every time the cache pipe is called, we are printing the URL data written from cache. Again, cache pipe call URL data written from cache. Okay, and again the same thing. That is, the data is called from the server only once here. Otherwise, after that, we are caching the data in the impure pipe, and in future, we are just invoking the data from the impure pipe. So we can also keep a simple button on this page just to see how the impure pipes are invoked with each and every event on the page, just to invoke a simple empty function. The app.component, I'm just simply going to write this empty function. So let's call this again. So you can see first time the data is written from the server, and later each and every time the data is written from the cache. So I will just clear this and click on the click button, and you can see now that actually the data is written from cache. So this is just to demonstrate that initially, first time the data is coming from the server, and after click or after any other event on the page, the data is actually called from the cache. So the reason to use impure pipe here is that if I remove pure equal to false here, then let's see what happens. So you can see cache pipe called and the server called, but the changes are actually not reflected in the grid. This is because this is called only once, and as you know, pure pipes actually require pure changes. It is not invoked each and every time. So impure pipes are actually invoked each and every time, even with a single click or mouse move or with every changes in the page. So I will just undo this and mark pure as false. And if you rerun this again, you can see, okay, again the data has been filled. First time from the server and later from the cache. So thus we have seen how to use the impure pipe for caching the data from the API. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. Kindly subscribe, like, or share.